Hi, welcome to my channel. I'm Tamitha Saunders. This is my first YouTube tutorial. I've been doing some reels on Facebook and stuff, having a lot of fun. So I thought that I would start doing some full tutorials. So I hope you like what you see. Just be patient. This is my first one, so hopefully they get better the more I do. But if you like what you see, go ahead and like and subscribe, and I hope to bring you more. Thank you. Let's get to it.
Okay, so for this tumbler, I got two different striped tumblers that I'm doing. I've got one already done, and I'm going to show you how I did this. And then this is the bottom so far. This is what it'll look like until we get a coat of epoxy on it, and then we'll put something on the bottom. So this cup has already been sanded, and I'm not spray painting it because it's going to be covered with the vinyl strips. And how I do that, these are all cut 1 inches, and I just pick random vinyls that I like, and then I just cut them off. I cut the 1-inch strips off, and then we apply them to the cup. Now the last strip will be a different size, but we're going to add a lot of texture and design to this cup, so you probably won't even notice it. Cut this, and then I'll do two slices this way so I can fold it over. Take it, always fold the two ends, and then fold the middle one last, and you just press it. Get it as tight as you can. And then I'm going to do the next one. We're going to go all the way around the cup doing this same process. And you just butt this one right next to the one you just applied. Cut down, down. Fold. Now all of these vinyls came from the vinyl craze. Sometimes I get it through vinyl craze, or I'll just order it through glitter craze. They're pretty much the same company, I believe. that's the good thing about not painting the cup. You don't have to worry about the paint peeling up when you make a mistake, or you got to get it tighter. We're going to be adding lots of different textures to this cup. Going to do on the bottom. I'm not sure if I'm just going to paint it or if I'm going to add a circle vinyl piece to it. I haven't really made my mind up yet, so, but by the time I'm done, I'll definitely know. There's so many different ideas, different ways you can do the bottoms of the cups. Some, you can even glitter the bottom if you want. Any of the stainless showing. That's the most important thing. I mean, but if you do accidentally get a little bit going, like I said, we're going to be adding lots of different textures to this cup. So it's not really a big deal. We'll be able to hide it okay. This one, this is a good example. Now see, you don't want to stick that one on upside down. So just be mindful as you're applying your strips. You don't want to get in a rush where you accidentally putting something on upside down and then you end up throwing epoxy over it or sealing it up. where I got something stuck under there. Ah, little teeny tiny piece of glitter. You see that? See how small that little last stripe is? I'm just going to put a small piece. I might have one already cut from the last one. Oh well, we'll pick one. To a half and just lay it right over top. Right over top. You know, we're going to be adding so much different stuff to this. It's not really, you're not going to notice the overlay. I didn't want to separate for me. Probably should have went with something lighter. Oh well. And there you have it. And we're going to put coats of epoxy on both of these. So for our cup, we're going to do some different kinds of paints and to add texture. So this one's a metallic accent. It's a rich, called rich brown. And then this one is a textured paste, copper crackle. And then we have a rust effect paste, brown rust. So I purchased all of these off of Amazon. So let's go. Sorry, I had to get my water ready. I didn't have my water ready. You can see I'm just doing like swoopy motions. I'm going to do this on the top and the bottom. Okay, now I'm just going to let that dry. I'm going to go in with the crackle next. Is getting that stir stick here. See, I just did some swoops. We'll be touching that up also. So we're also going to be putting some glitter down and different such. Now this one I'm just going to use a little fine brush. This is the textured rust. This is what I got for the texture. I'm just going to let all that dry first. Going to put a little bit in the lid. Don't need a lot. Now this one right here I don't care for, so I'm going to kind of get rid of some of it and some up here to hide some of it. Thank you. And we're going to use Cordelia from Mr. Nola's glitter. See all that sparkle? So pretty. I'm just picking random spots or like the spots that I don't like very well. That's all I'm doing. This is what I got so far. Find my brush. This one. Oh, I can't find my other paintbrush. Let's see if this one will work. Just trying to brush some of the glitter off. When it dries, we'll brush over top of them. So I really don't want to do that until the Mod Podge dries. Got so far, and then we're probably going to do another coat on top just to make sure we got good coverage. I'm not putting none on the bottom, but if you'd like to put some on the bottom of yours, you can do that. I just want to try to have that as smooth as possible for epoxy.